From the MidwestSports.net studio, this is Midwest Sports Saturday. Hi, I'm Joey McWilliams. It's an abbreviated episode of the program this week as we are in studio. We'll be back on the road next week on campus, and we'll be in Oklahoma City. A little bit more about that later on. Today's program is also highlighted by a visit with a couple of student-athletes from Arkansas who both had historic nights for the Central Baptist College program on Tuesday night. That's coming up in just a moment. Right now, let's talk some women's basketball, NAIA and NCAA. We look at the Division II NAIA poll in women's basketball. Concordia no longer the number one team in the country, as it has fallen two spots after a loss to Hastings, has won two games since then. Now 16-2 on the year is Concordia at number three. By the way, Southeastern Florida in at the number one spot. College of the Ozarks in at number six in this number three poll on the year. Number seven is Morningside, as the Mustangs have won five straight, now 16-4 on the year. We move a little bit farther down. Sterling in at number 19 in this poll. And entering the poll, Kansas Wesleyan in at the number 24 spot. That's Division II NAIA women's basketball. NAIA Division I, Oklahoma City just behind the Masters, as the Stars are in at number 2. 15-0 on the year. Abby Seltzer putting in 16.7 points per game. She'll have an opportunity to go up against Alexis Shannon next Saturday. Shannon from Mid-America Christian, number 5 in the country in scoring at 19.3 points per game. And that's where we'll be with Midwest Sports Saturday next week on the campus of OCU Abe Lemons Arena. And please tune in for that. I look forward to it. Should be a very good doubleheader, as Oklahoma City is number 2 in the country in the women's basketball poll. Mid-America Christian, number 2 in the country in the men's basketball poll. So I'll have some good competition next week. We'll be streaming live at 11 a.m. Central Time from the campus of OCU. That is next week. OCU in again at number 2 in the women's basketball poll. Central Methodist at number 8 right now, as Mercedes Jefflow and Lainey Rodney, 10 and 11 in the NAI in scoring respectively, putting in right about the same amount of points, as Jefflow has 18 points per game. Rodney has 17.9 points per game. And Central Methodist, 15-2 on the year, in again at number 8, had a 9-game winning streak stopped against William Penn, as William Penn won in overtime 62-60 over Central Methodist. But the Eagles still in at number 8 right now in the poll. Lion at 15-1 on the year, and the Scots are in at number 10 in the Division I NAIA poll. Also from the MidwestSports.net area, Columbia at 13-3 on the year is number 15 in the poll. And also Grandview, number 19, 14-3. Clark, number 21, 14-3. And Grandview will host Clark on Monday. So a big matchup there. That is in the heart, so be looking for that on Monday. Now, we continue talking NAIA women's basketball, and let's talk about a special night for the Central Baptist College Mustangs. Holly Allen and Kory Westerman both were big in a performance, a 102-49 victory over Crowley Ridge College. And it was just a big night for both of them, as Allen had 10 three-pointers made, a school record, and Westerman put together the first triple-double in school history. And we had a chance to hear from both of them a little bit earlier.
We're here with a special segment, MidwestSports.net College Game Day. I'm Eric Holt, the Central Baptist College Sports Information Director. I've got Kory Westerman and Holly Allen, both of the CBC women's basketball team, both made history Tuesday night against Crowley's Ridge in a 102-49 victory. Kory had the first triple-double in school history. Holly hit a school record 10 three-pointers in a single game. First, Kory, we'll start with you. Talk a little bit about the triple-double and what went into that.
I mean, we just went into last night's game like it was any other game. Both of us knew that we had a chance to possibly break some records, and I was actually trying to go for a rebounding record, but my halftime coach kind of came up to me and he was like, "Hey, you're at 8 steals." And I think I had like 5 rebounds. I didn't have very many points at that time, but he was like, "You could go for the first triple-double in school history." And I was like, "All right, like, let's do that." And from there, the team knew what was happening. Holly knew what was happening and helped support, so everyone else kind of helped contribute. So it was definitely a team effort, and I'm just really thankful that they helped and that coach was there to push and believe in me along the way.
And Holly, you had 10 threes, 34 points. You had 6 threes in the fourth quarter. talk a little bit about late in the game and what was going through your mind there.
I shot a lot of threes. they were looking for me the whole, especially second half. They knew where I was at, and coach was like, all right, let's try to get her the ball. You know, I was doing my best to find the screens, find the open shot. It was tough, but my teammates were there screening for me, looking for me on the passes, and I was just thinking, if I can do this, you know, make some history on this night. Kory texted me like two nights ago. It was like 11 o'clock at night. She was like, we're going to break some records. We're gonna make history Tuesday night. And I said, let's do it. And that's what happened. So,
10 3-pointers. Have you ever done that before?
No. That's my first, I think my first 30-point game ever, probably, at least in a long time. So it was a good night.
And Kory, when you had 8 steals in the first half, what was going through your mind?
I mean, I knew I had quite a few, but I had no idea when coach told me that it was 8, and then he came up to me at halftime. He said, do you want me to put the pressure on you or no? And I was like, let's hear it. And he was like, you're 1 steal from tying the record, 2 from getting it. And I was like, I knew from then on that I had to go do that. So that was all in my mind the second half, was just trying to get the steals and then the rest of the stats to finish the triple-double.
And your guys' records kind of happened one right after the other. You got the steal, converted that into points, and you had to get your points at the free throw line. To talk a little bit about the pressure of that.
Well, I had just missed a wide-open layup almost to get the 10th point to seal it, and so when I was at the free throw line, I'm not going to lie, I was praying, and I was like, all right, God, it's me and you right now, like, we're going to do this, but I made that first free throw, and I knew once I did that one, I was like, this next one's about to do it, so it was pretty exciting.
And Holly, you hit yours with about a minute left. You had 9 before that. Talk a little bit about that, too.
Well, I had people on the sideline. Corey's like, Holly, just let it happen. Just let it happen. Because I was like, when you're in that excitement, the crowd's got you going, they know you're 1-3 away from, you know, setting a record. I was frazzled. I was shaking. I'm not going to lie. My shots, I didn't think were going to go in. The ones that did, I was like, all right, thank you. But the crowd gets you going. The sideline gets me going. The teammates, they all want it to happen. So that's why I did.
Awesome. Kory, Holly, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Special thanks to Eric Holth, the Sports Information Director at Central Baptist College, for providing that video, and to Holly Allen and to Kory Westerman for sitting in and taking the opportunity to visit with us about that big night. By the way, Allen finished with 34 points on the night. And again, Westerman's triple-double, 10 points, 12 rebounds, 11 steals. The 10 three-pointers made by Allen, a school record. The 11 steals, a school record. A big, big night. Central Baptist now 10-5 on the year. Is on the road today to take on St. Louis College of Pharmacy. That's game 2 of a 4-game road swing before heading back. And by the way, also, a programming note, as Midwest Sports Saturday will be in Conway, Arkansas in February. So be looking forward to that. Now to Division II women's basketball, and we look at the top 25 poll as we wrap up our day here on Midwest Sports Saturday. Drury, the number one team in the country, continues to be the number one team in the country. 15-0 are the Panthers now after a 70-60 victory over Maryville this week, and on the road to take on Missouri S&T in Rolla today. Number 13, Fort Hays State. It was a top 15 matchup, by the way, a little bit earlier this week on Wednesday night, as Fort Hays State, number 13 in the country, hosted the number 15 Emporia State Hornets. And it was just domination for the Tigers. It was a big win on Wednesday night. In fact, 87-55 was the final score. Casey Kennett led the way for the Tigers with 16 points. 6 players in double figures for Fort Hays State in the win. Mounsey led the way for Emporia State with 23, a game high on the night, and went 7-for-10 from behind the arc. So Fort Hays State now at 14-2 on the season, hosting Washburn today. Number 15 Emporia State goes on the road to try to rebound, and they are at Nebraska Kearney today. Also, the number 18 team in the country is from the MidwestSports.net region, and that is the Southeastern Oklahoma State Savage Storm. 11-2 now on the year, number 18 in the country, defeated rival East Central on Thursday night, 63-41, to continue to roll in the Great American Conference on the road against defending GAC champion and defending national runner-up Southwestern Oklahoma State today. So that's going to wrap things up from the studio today. Again, we'll be on the road at Oklahoma City University next Saturday as OCU will be hosting Mid-America Christian, a big doubleheader in the NAI, and we will be there streaming live at 11 a.m. Central Time from OCU. I'm Joey McWilliams. Thanks for watching. Special thanks again to Eric Holth from Central Baptist, and also special thanks to Holly Allen and to Kory Westerman for sitting in. I appreciate them taking time out of their week to visit with us and to visit with you as well. Please be sure and like and share this video, and please do subscribe to this YouTube channel, to the Midwest Sports Net YouTube channel. It is a growing channel, and we just enjoy providing quality content, sports talk, small college basketball, small college sports, football, you name it. We're right here in the Midwest with Arkansas and Oklahoma, Iowa, Nebraska, Missouri, and Kansas, and a whole lot more. Again, thanks for watching today. God bless you, and have a great day.